Shadreck, man, welcome. Thank you for welcoming us to this space.
Thank you.
It's beautiful. How did you come up to this place?
So, this space is a space that is dedicated mostly to historical. And the idea here is to have it's a residency. So, 2 or 3 months of a year, things starting from next year, will be dedicated to the residency where artists. Just like any other residency. And so I think starting from next year we'll be rolling out a call for applications. We are still working on this piece of land, but as you can see, it's a huge piece of land. So also my wife and myself are developing this, and as I said, mostly dedicated.
So we've just come from doing an amazing festival, the Feminas Book and Arts and Book Festival. I mean, what was the idea? I mean, why did you do that festival?
So the festival, Feminas, is a section of the Story Club. Feminas simply means art for feminism. And the festival is a Feminas Arts and Book Festival. So a festival, a book festival, an arts festival, that centers its discussions and focus on feminism. We believe in the Story Club, art for its own sake, but also art as a tool for social change. And feminism is one of the things that we talk about. And we had come to a point where we said, we've talked about it enough. Let's have a festival where we can bring these ideas together, speak to artists, speak to ourselves, just dig deep into what is feminism and how can the arts incorporate that in the art. Because really Malawi is very patriarchal. I think more than many spaces in the world. And so this is an issue we can't avoid. We have to talk about that. Women being marginalized and the society not being equal to both men and women. And so that's what the festival was all about.
So I see your festival headliner was leading feminist thinker Tizi Dangarengwa, and she gave a powerful keynote address. How was that?
We couldn't think of anybody who is better than Tizi Dangarengwa to be the inaugural headliner. As you know, Tsitsi has written on feminism. She is the pioneer before anybody else started talking about feminism in Africa. Tsitsi was there. She published a book in 1988, and it's a strong feminist. It's become a feminist manifesto for Africa and for many other parts of the world. There's nobody who is better placed to give this festival the focus it needs, the depth it needs, but also just to program it in a manner that it makes sense, because really it's not just about one person or two people, it's about everybody. That's why we had to do all we could to have it sit in the Karemba headline this festival.
So, I mean, you've done a festival for 2 days. Do you think you succeeded?
The turnout was a huge surprise to us, because this is the first time we're doing this in Malawi. In the history of Malawi, this is the first time. And even by the last minutes, we were not ready with preparations. We still thought we had not done enough. But the turnout was so huge. And the content was so deep and intense. Children came and performed and talked about girl power. They read their poetry. They read their essays. We're talking of children that are as young as 12 years old. There were lots of things. There's music. There was a band, the Daughters Band, which is actually a band of women. Sorry, and they performed. They're beautiful. Just to show how that women are able, that we are able, that men and women are not really different when it comes to the arts and such kind of things. It was so beautiful. Second day was so beautiful. We had people travel all the way from Zomba, all the way from Planta, all the way from Nzuzu. We had a huge turn up, and this just shows how much that this country needs this kind of conversations and dialogue.
So now that you had a sort of successful festival, are we looking forward to another one next year? Or?
I can say for sure that we're having another festival, another seminar. The second chapter is coming in October next year. That we can assure everybody that yes, this is something that's going to be annual, come rain, come sunshine.
Okay, so, and are you going to be inviting other people apart from outside of the Malawi?
So the idea is really to have a cocktail of the arts. So Malawian artists from Africa, from different countries, artists from outside Africa. The whole idea really is to have this art speak unto the issue.
And my last question is about Malawian Malawi art scene. The last 2 days we've seen really amazing performances of art, music, dance, poetry, and I'm just curious, why don't we know more about Malawi across the continent?
You see, also as Malawians, we have to know more. When you go, for example, on Twitter, you don't find the presence of Malawi as much as you find. It's not as vibrant. So to learn to use the social media, to learn to network, there isn't much of that in Malawi. Networking with fellow Malawian artists, but also to connect with the outside, but also the corporate world and the government, they're not, keen on the arts. And so we still have a long way ourselves to learn, to appreciate our art. And then only after that can the entire world zero in on Malawi. I think it starts with us. And that's what the Story Club is all about, to drum up the arts and to invite people from different parts of the world. James Murua is an international blogger from Kenya, who is known on the whole continent in Africa. And that's why we had to invite him, because this is another way of exporting our art, even as he writes, even as he blogs internationally. This is what the Story Club believes in, exporting our art through different forums and the like.
Last one. What artists? I mean, we saw Lily performing amazingly. So, could you give me some names of some artists we need to be looking out for?
We have,
from Malawi.
We have, for example, George Kalukusha. He is an amazing musician. We have writers like Andrew Dakalila from Malawi, an amazing science fiction writer. We have Wambali Nkandawile, Peter Mawanga, F.L. Kamwendo, and many other artists that are really not known outside, but who are huge and very articulate and very fine in their art.